NASCAR race at Charlotte Motor Speedway had it all, including the big one, Shannon. It was a night to remember.
Yes, it was, Adam. And a big one at Charlotte, sort of inevitable considering the fact that we were pack racing and so much was on the line while really nothing was on the line. We saw how it started. We saw the outcome. Here's what a couple of the drivers involved had to say.
Four wide going into three there. We just all kind of ran out of room. I think the 17, I had him squeezed down so low. I just don't know that he could hold it down there. And I knew we had to get through that green white checker to have a shot to win, but I also knew if I would have lifted there, and I'd have been the only one left, and the guys I was racing with would have went on the pass.
Something happened here right in front of me. We had a great restart, and we were passing cars, and I just almost cleared it, and it tore the radiator out.
Times during the open, but it didn't quite look like that. When's the last time we said there was a big one in Charlotte?
So take us through exactly what happened. Show us the players that were involved in this, Larry.
I think what you want to keep an eye on is right there. There you see it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Track's wide enough. I'm just not sure, though, that it's
going
to work.
Yeah, and I'm right here, and I'm already kind of seeing this going, that doesn't look very good. So I was kind of checking up right there just to see what it played out as.
You're dropping back real quick.
And I've got to believe one of the biggest challenges with this package at Charlotte is the track is so narrow, you're just not used to putting yourself in these situations.
Well, and the thing is a couple things happened. This is a green-white checkered that's leading into the final 10 laps. Everybody knows that it's all about track position for those last 10 laps. So it's no give. As we see right here, everybody's trying to take. Martin's trying to get to the bottom. Ricky's saying, hey, my nose is under you already. I'm not lifting. And with this package as well, you could not get out of the throttle. If you got out of the throttle and checked up, they would run over you from behind.
You can see right there, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. was starting to move down the racetrack, but Truex just moving. And you see right here, Ricky is already down pretty low. But you can see on that last shot where Truex right here, he was starting to come down a little more and a little more and a little more. I mean, you're going to see sparks fly from the 17 car, Ricky Stenhouse. He's below the apron.
And that's the apron right there. So once you start getting down there, there's nothing he can do. At this point, Martin's trying to get to the white line. There's no more room left. They hook him, and then everybody that's above Martin Truex Jr. gets involved.
Bottom line, overtime, late in the All-Star race. To his point, everybody's taking, nobody's giving.
So it was all take and no give at the end of stage three. What could possibly go wrong in the final stage? Kyle Larson and Joey Logano get us there.
No, he just came in a wall, and we played it after that. So that's his fault.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just trying to carry as much throttle as I can. The package pretty slow, and I just got really, really tight. I tried to bail, he tried to leave me as much room as he could, and I was trying to leave him room, you know, once I realized I wasn't really going to make the corner, and shoved him in the wall, and he obviously retaliated, but, it is what it is, I guess. You know, I don't want to be frustrated because I got wrecked on purpose, but I put him in the fence, too.
Continue the next level as we take a look at what happened between the 42 and the 22. You heard what the guy said. Yeah, it's my fault. Yeah, he ran me in the wall. All right, we got $1 million on the line. Any way to avoid this?
Not really. Two to go for $1 million. It's all take. So, as Kyle Larson says, he gets tight. He gets off the white line. If you got off the white line and you were still staying in the throttle, the car just went turn. So, Joey Logano, middle of 3 and 4, has a big run. He's not lifting. Kyle's trying to give him room, but at that point, as he gets tight, he starts losing a little bit of air off the right side of the car, runs Joey into the wall off the corner. Joey says at this point, hey, that's not very cool. He makes a hard left just to show Kyle Larson his disapproval. And then this happens, and Kyle goes spinning through the grass.
Yeah, it's like Kyle said. He said, I had to roll out of the throttle. I'm not going to make the corner. He had the wheels turned. But he was trying to stay off the wall to give Joey room, but it just ran out of room right there. Joey gets in the wall because of what a run he has. But then you're going to see right here as we move forward, he didn't take too kindly to what Kyle Larson did, and this could have been big.
The naked eye, it's hard to see, but Kyle Larson's got so much wheel in front of his car. He's so tired right now. His car is going this way.